Morning, everyone. This is Lisa Listen with Are You My Cousin blog, and I am so excited to talk with you this morning and actually post to you about the National Genealogical Society's 2017 Family History Conference. This is actually early morning before the beginning of my second day there, and I'm super excited. I've been talking with really great friends, meeting up with new friends, and talking to vendors, and trying to answer some of the questions that you as readers have and do in genealogy, since you cannot be here yourselves. So I'm super excited to be able to be your eyes and ears for the National Genealogical Society's conference this year. So today what I'm going to talk to you briefly before I head back out to the conference are some genealogical gleanings that I've gotten from the first day of the conference. And one of the things I wanted to share with you is, as we all know, genealogy and DNA, that's where it's at, guys. DNA is so popular these days, and I will confess to you right now, I am not a DNA expert, and I'm still in that learning process and really enjoying the process, but it definitely, as you enter into using DNA with your genealogy, take the time to learn how to use it. There are some fabulous resources, and that's really what I wanted to bring up with you this morning. When you attend a conference, whether it's a large conference such as a National Genealogical Conference, or whether it's a small regional conference or even just a local society conference, those are fabulous opportunities for education. And in the larger settings, oftentimes the DNA companies that are promoting selling the DNA kits, such as MyHeritage or Ancestry DNA or Family Tree DNA, MyHeritage DNA, they offer small breakout sessions, usually very specific to DNA and how to use it, test on their sites, how to interpret the data and how it's presented on their particular site and by their particular company. And then, of course, there are other larger, broader lectures that you can attend to learn about DNA in general. Now, the reason I bring that up is I recognize that many of you cannot attend a national conference or one of these larger conferences and talk to the companies on their own, but many of them offer online tutorials so that you can learn. I know that when I first started testing and started out with the Family Tree DNA testing, I actually went to their YouTube page. They have YouTube videos on their DNA and results and how to interpret them quite detailed, and I learned a tremendous amount of information that way. So that's a great way to further your DNA and genealogy education if you're not able to attend a conference. Now, another thing that's really a really great resource and that you might want to consider are certainly books, and the National Genealogical Society is actually debuting a book by Blaine Bettinger, and I can't remember his co-author. I'm going to link to it at the end of the bottom of this post so you can find it, on genetic genealogy, and it's actually a workbook as well. So it is very interactive, and I think that's going to be very helpful as well. So I'm super excited to really get hold of one of those and start looking at that and working through that as well. So, guys, it is very early here in North Carolina, but I wanted to go ahead and get this information out to you. Please, if you're interested in kind of seeing what's going on at NGS, absolutely go ahead and like my Facebook page, follow my Facebook page, because I will be posting updates and pictures and things like that. If you're at the conference, be sure to stop by and say hello. I'd love to meet my readers. So other than that, go out and have a great day, guys, and find some ancestors. Have a great day. Bye.